Do you have any advice for me to want to try to break in and hopefully one day get to work with you on a movie, man?
So don't view it as break in, right? Unless you're talking about something like wrestling, where you do need the help. You can make wrestling videos in your backyard. Be safe. Don't try this at home. I'm a professional. But with nowadays, given technology, you can kind of create your own world and everything. That little device everybody takes pictures and videos with, that's one hell of a camera. If you want to act, act. Like, that's just do. Don't worry about your big break. I believe good work begets another chance. And that may not be the chance to be on, like, a movie poster or whatever. If you do good work enough times, you're going to find a level of fluency and joy in what you do. So acting's easy, especially now. It used to be like wrestling. Wrestling really used to be secretive. Killer Kowalski School, where Paul Levesque was trained, was 25 minutes from my house in West Newbury, Massachusetts. I had to move to Los Angeles to go to wrestling school, and I found that freaking place by accident. So it used to be very protected. Nowadays, there isn't a, there's not a, it's like a gold rush for entertainment. So if you want to act, put yourself out there. You never know who's going to see it.
Thank you, man.
Hello, John. My name's Winston. This is a very surreal pitch me moment for me right now to be speaking to you.
Here we are.
I just want to tell you thank you again, like just like everybody's been saying. I'm also a educator right now, sports coach for football and basketball.
Right on.
Watching you since 2002 to today, a lot of your life values, the hustle, loyalty, respect, and never give up attitude, I apply that to my kids at the high school, right? And the special education department is where I work at. So I just want to thank you for that.
And thank you.
For where you have me at today. Going back to my question that I want to ask you, I want to take you back to ECW One Night Stand.
Oh boy, that's a fun one.
Versus Rob Van Dam.
Yeah.
The biggest underdog of the night going into that match. What was your mentality to prepare for that match? Were there any takeaways that you got? And what was, like, I guess your favorite memory from that night?
So when you, I'll answer your question with a question. When you say biggest underdog, what do you mean? Like, I was the biggest underdog?
Well, correct. From the crowd perspective standpoint, yeah. They were, you know, throwing your t-shirt back. And
Do you mind if I change your words?
Sure.
I was really hated that night.
There you go.
going into a WWE event as a WWE champion, to try to compete with a company that had folded, I would actually say I was the odds-on favorite, and Rob Van Dam would be the underdog. And I think that's what made that night, that audience, really special. It's because I stood for everything that that place didn't want to be like. We all met in the canvas and ropes and turnbuckles, but their lane was different than mine. If a representative from the ECW of the 90s was up here, chances are they wouldn't be in dress shoes and a waistcoat. Even Paul Heyman. But that's what made the brand special, and that's what made that moment special. That's one of the most connected I've ever felt with an audience. If I had to do it again, I wish we had another hour so I could fight with a t-shirt. I was in the ring with one of the most gifted athletic performers I've ever had a chance to touch hands with, and all I wanted to do was fight a t-shirt, because the audience wanted in the ring, and that shirt was a vehicle for them to get in the ring, and it was great, because there's no better feeling as a performer, trust me, and this is why, man, all these rules they got, you're not supposed to, and I don't say it apathetically, the rules that they have are in place for a reason. But when I make bold choices to try and fail, like looking in the camera to the people at home, or talking to Stu, my Steadicam guy, to let him know I appreciate him, and so you guys appreciate it before we go to work, and taking time to look at the audience when I'm speaking to you guys, and not just speak to the person at home, because we're all here together, and I want as much insight as I can. There's not a better feeling for a performer than when you are automatically connected. And when I walked, or when the crowd began to walk into that building, 6:30 p.m. brings so much joy to, I'm pretty sure, everybody here, as well as me and my family personally, so thank you so much for that. My question for you is, out of your dad's cameos on TV, especially WWE television, which one would you say is your favorite?
When Edge went to his house, only because I remember it was so bad they almost didn't use it.